Hello friends, so today I am going to tell you that RDS database is a database that is available on AWS, and it can be connected with our local system, and it can be utilized in our local level programming also. Database will be available on the cloud, but the connection of that can be made in NetBean with the PHP program or your Python programming or your Java database programming. It can be connected with that. So as you are looking, there is one option, RDS is there, relational database system. So already I created one database and that is running on my AWS account. So you can see there dashboard, instances, cluster, all are there. So just I am clicking on instances, and then you are looking, my database is already working. If you want to launch any new database instance, then you can go here and then you can select any database like Amazon or a database MySQL, etc. So I selected MySQL database, MySQL. So I selected MySQL database, and I am working with that. So I am going back to in instances. Today I am not going to tell you that how to create Amazon RDS database, but already I am having one database. So just my database instance is running. Just I have to click on it. And after clicking on that, you will be seeing then lot of information about my database is available there. But exactly at this place, I am not getting any information that how to access it directly in GUI mode. So friends, but connection information is available there. My database URL is available there, and port 3306. This is the standard port of MySQL. So this information is available there. But you have to do one more change. As you are looking, that I made a small change there, publicly accessible or not, because if it is publicly not accessible, no is written there, then this URL cannot be accessed on your local PC. So what you have to do, you have to go into the security groups, and in security group, because already changes are there, so you have to allow that, you have to allow like inbound. All these are there, like all TCP and all ports and from anywhere. But now go back and then see one more change. Okay. So publicly accessible, it is there. So if you want to change it, then you can do a small change inside that. I did enable it. Now I am finding that from where I did that. So instance action, like create, clone, modify. So you have to go in modify. In modify, you will be looking database options, backup, monitoring, maintenance. Publicly accessible. When you are creating it, by default this option will be on, so you have to deselect it and select this one. So after that, your database will be publicly accessible. So now I am going back to my database. Now in my database, just you have to click on it and see what is the URL. So this is the URL that can be utilized. Okay, already I created.
Hello दोस्तों, हमारी वीडियो को लाइक एवं सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें. आपको हमारी वीडियो को लाइक करने के लिए इस आइकन पर क्लिक करना होगा, तथा सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए आपको इस बॉक्स पर क्लिक करना पड़ेगा. आप हमारी वीडियो को सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए इस बेल आइकन पर भी क्लिक कर सकते हैं. इन दोनों का एडवांटेज आपको ये रहेगा कि जब भी हमारी कोई नई एक इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियो आएगी, तो आपके यूट्यूब अकाउंट के टॉप पर बेल आइकन पर एक अलर्ट आ जाएगा.
क्रिएटेड, सो इफ यू वांट टू कनेक्ट इट विद नेटबीन, देन इट कैन बी कनेक्टेड विद नेटबीन. और इफ यू वांट टू कनेक्ट इट विद लाइक जैम सर्वर, लैम्प सर्वर, देन लैम्प सर्वर डाटाबेस, देन इट कैन बी कनेक्टेड विद दैट. And there is very good option of accessing the database then with the help of like you can see as I am writing there, then my web SQL option is also there. It can be downloaded and it can be connected. So if you want to connect with this one, then I will tell you option to you, but before that I am telling how to connect it with NetBean. So in NetBean, just I am clicking here and then I am writing new connection. So what new connection? That is my SQL connector. Next, now you are being asked that with which database you want to create the connection. So you are writing the complete information about that. I pasted URL here and MySQL, because MySQL is the default database of any MySQL server, so it can be connected with that. Already I created one username on my Amazon web server, on my Amazon database RDS service, and that username is root, and now I am going to put my password. Now I am going to test this connection. It may be refusing because I am using a different type of internet connection. If it is refusing, then I have to connect it with other connection, that is Jio available with me. I think same problem is there. So now friends, I am changing the internet connection. So just I am clicking on it. Okay, connection succeeded. This was the problem of internet connection. Now finish it. Okay, it is saying connection already exists. Okay, so when you will be creating it first time, then no problem will be there. So now see. Okay. So just connect it. Okay, so I able to connect to my RDS, relational database system of Amazon, and what type of tables, etc., all are accessible there. So okay, now I am going to tell you that how you have to make connection with this my web SQL web. So this is my web SQL that is available to access database, MySQL database, in a GUI fashion. It is just like workbench. Now I am going to project OD. This is my place to work. So now you will be seeing my web SQL is there. In my web SQL you will be seeing that config is available there. Inside this config you will be seeing servers, what type of database servers you want to connect with that. So now come back here, open it in Notepad. In Notepad, when you are opening it, then you can see that localhost MySQL is there, SQLite can be connected with that, and AWS MySQL. So you have to add only this one more text inside it. Inside that, what change you have to made? As I told you, there is a URL, there is one URL on Amazon AWS, and that URL is available here. So just you have to copy paste here at the place of this local host, you have to paste it here. So same thing is available here. So after that, when you are just switch off it and you are going to MySQL, then just log out it, because I am running this from the local system. After this much of change, you will be seeing AWS my web MySQL is there. So I will be changing the username and password of that, and then just login it. It will be taking some time really, because it is working on Amazon and depends upon the speed of your internet. But really friends, this is very very important for you, because when we are working with cloud, then how to use the cloud in many different fashions. So I already created one database on that, and that database is this PRE, and inside that I created one table PRE. Okay, so friends, thank you.